Hello again and welcome. This is module 4.1 of the ServiceNow Administrator Certification Program. And in module 4, we're going to talk about knowledge management. That's 4.1. Service catalog is going to be 4.2. Workflows is going to be 4.3. And SLAs is going to be 4.4. So this is going to be a module series of videos, four videos. I hope that you find them really useful to you. You know, knowledge is definitely one of the biggest assets that an organization has to maintain in place, because by gathering information and evaluating that information, analyzing it, we can assist those in charge in making strategic decisions for the organization as the organization moves into the future. By having the ability to evaluate the patterns of business activity over a series of time, so that we can attempt to forecast how the business is going to behave moving forward. And so ServiceNow, you know, this platform allows you the ability to create a logical environment within the application, so that you can create articles, so that you can create knowledge bases, and so that you can have different categories where those articles are going to belong, so that we can have information organized in a way within the organization that is pragmatic and that is easy to search, so that we minimize the impact of rediscovery. And basically what rediscovery means is rediscovery is when an organization has to rediscover, in essence, every single time a problem arises, the possible solution, is because they don't have a knowledge database. If we have a documentation of everything that happens within the organization, things that make an impact within the individual departments or the individual groups, then it's gonna be a lot more difficult to become an enterprise service management organization that is that operates at today's speed in which things are happening in our world. And so you cannot rely anymore on mom and pop, you know, to tell you stories about, you know, how things used to be done before, but rather, you know, we have a repository on the cloud where we store all kinds of information that can be tabulated into data that can be analyzed by utilizing graphs and pies and lines. In order to represent the information in a way that can be easily disseminated into the organization, to the different individuals within the organization, including those working on the ground, you know, actually making things happen, and then those who are deciding or strategizing within an IT environment. And so ServiceNow, as I mentioned earlier, gives you the ability to create this logical environment by giving you the tools, the interface necessary to manage the knowledge within the business. In fact, you know, if you search online for jobs such as a knowledge management or, you know, knowledge expert, this is definitely one of the areas that is exploding, and where, you know, the need for skilled workers is necessary as we speak right now. You know, and I'm sitting here July 20-something 2017, but things are happening really fast, and unless we get on board, you know, with how things are managed to make an organization or an IT organization or the IT aspect of the organization more effective, is to get up to speed with, making sure that we manage all the information that's coming into the organization or information that is being created by individuals that are employees of the organizations, or information that, needs to be released out into the public. We need to manage what information gets released, what information is proprietary, needs to be stored in a, within the database of the organization, information that has to do with, sensitive information where security is a of priority, then we might need to secure that information and only give access to individuals who have the authority within the company to have access to that knowledge, right? And so we disseminate the knowledge to the public in a way that makes sure that there is steps or checkpoints, in essence, a workflow of how the data gets released into the public. So somebody has to take responsibility, or somebody has to be responsible, right? We're talking probably, marketing team or a PR team, who are maybe responsible, in working with other individuals in the organization, or even with lawyers and attorneys who might need to review some of these articles to make sure that information that's being made public does not, hinder the well-being of the organization. And so there's just so many reasons as to why you would want to manage knowledge. I'm just kind of putting it out there, right? The other aspect of that is that we want to minimize rediscovery, right? We don't want to have to be reinventing the wheel. If we already tried something in the past and it's fully documented, then we can either take that information and build on that, or we can take the lessons learned and say, you know what, we're just going to extract that knowledge, and we're not going to move forward, but we're going to use that knowledge to apply it to something different, right? And that's just an example of how knowledge, if you will, can influence the decision-making process within an organization. And so we have to make sure that we document everything that happens within the company. Every interaction with a customer, every phone call needs to be documented. Every meeting there needs to be minutes, or if possible, recordings or video recordings of the conferences and the lectures and the presentations, so that we have a repository of everything that the company builds from an intangible perspective. And so you basically, within a company, a company's security policy on regards to knowledge would be that we only allow, access to information to people who need the access in order to perform their work. And so there may be some other security aspects of ServiceNow, and that's why only individuals who are either administrators within the ServiceNow instance, or individuals who have a knowledge underscore admin role, right? So basically, there is a table within ServiceNow called the knowledge underscore admin. And so if an administrator can add an individual who may need access to manage some of the knowledge processes within the company, an individual might need to be added into the knowledge underscore admin table. And so your job might be that you get a work order where you have to go into the instance and you have to, create a user, maybe because this is a new employee that's being hired by the organization. And so you're gonna need to create a user and then drop that user into a group, and then maybe, have a group where you have knowledge underscore admins already as a group, or you might need to go into the knowledge underscore admin table to make sure that you allocate, or that you delegate rather, the proper role to the individuals who need access to the knowledge bases. Okay, knowledge articles exist within knowledge bases, so this is really important. Okay, because this might actually be test material here for the administrator certification. Okay, so knowledge articles exist within knowledge bases. So first, the first thing that you create is a knowledge base, and then within that knowledge base, you're gonna have categories, and then within those categories, in essence, you have knowledge articles. And what is a knowledge article? Well, it's basically a release, a document, you know, some text that you type into a box that will, in essence, become part of a web page that will eventually be released in you know, to the individuals who need access to it, or to groups of individuals, or to roles within the organization, or to a public arena, if you will. Okay. So, you know, it could be that you're going to have a multiple knowledge managers within an organization, because, you know, you're going to have people who are managing information from different departments. And so you're going to have experts within every one of the departments within an organization. So you might have an expert in human resources. You might have an expert in shipping and receiving, another expert in customer service, another expert in, you know, insurance or booking, or the financial department, or security, IT security department, and so on and so forth. And so desktop support, or hardware managers, or software managers, right, would be, or operational managers would be the people who might to some extent need access to this knowledge database from an administrative perspective, so that they can approve or disapprove, you know, articles that are being created by individuals within the company who want to release that information, whether, you know, it's to a group or whether it's to a public, right? We want to have a process in place where people cannot publicize articles without going through a process of approval, right? And that process of approval has to be pragmatic. It can, you know, it cannot be a process that slows the process down, but rather it has to be a process that speeds things up. And so that's why what we want to do is we want to have a process within ServiceNow where, you know, if somebody makes an article, they can go through a process where a manager would need to go through the material, or, you know, a series of individuals may need to authorize the release of that information before it can actually be released. And that creates a layer of protection, if you will, right, for the individual who created the document, because you don't want to get in trouble, in essence, by writing things or releasing information that is proprietary to the organization. So I know this slide right here looks very intimidating, but as I've said before, you know, in essence, what we're trying to do is we are trying to establish the different levels of how information is stored within ServiceNow, so that we have a better understanding of where our information is and how to troubleshoot issues with data or issues with the ESM. In this case, ServiceNow, of course. But, and so, you know, you're going to have a knowledge management base, in essence, or a service knowledge management base. And so within that management base, you have, you know, the ability to create reports, or to query, or to analyze, or to create models, or to, you know, forecast or plan and budget. But then on the other end, toward the, you know, ground aspect of things, or the raw aspects of things, you know, from data and information sources and tools aspects of things, you know, we're also storing CMDBs, which is the configuration management database that contain information about everything that the company, you know, has. Things about, it contains information about legacy systems, you know, applications, you know, files, and you know, other types of data that are necessary to basically run the information. So, but don't be intimidated by this. I think, you know, I only put this out here to say that, you know, your job might be that you have to manage the information from all these different aspects of the organization. And so you have all this, you have these different layers, right, where you have data, you know, that's raw data, and then you have information that has been compiled, if you will, so that it can be so that it can be interpreted by individuals, and that's where the knowledge processing layer kicks in, right? Because the individuals are the ones that are going to be, you know, running reports and going into ServiceNow, and maybe, you know, interacting with ServiceNow through gauges, so that through the portal they can have a good understanding of the services and the assets and the performance of the organization, you know, and so that we can also give every individual a self-service view so that they can access certain aspects of the database and basically, in essence, manage their own account and their own information that they create and all information that has been created, that has been shared with them, and so that they have the ability to interact within their role with aspects of the database that are crucial to performing their work. Okay, so in essence, what is it that we're trying to do, right? We're trying to move information from its data state, which is raw information, but we want to allow that information to evolve, if you will, from its raw data to wisdom, right? Where we're actually making data-driven decisions because we have a very clear understanding of all the different gears that are turning within your company. And so basically, what is it that we're trying to do? We're trying to have a better understanding of what is happening within the organization, right? Or within the company, or, you know, within my IT department, if you look at it from an IT perspective, whereby we are taking data and we are basically answering the questions, the who, the what, the when, and the where, right? That when you take data and you take it from its raw state to a tabular form, for example, a graph, right? A graph is information. A graph pie is information. A graph of lines is information that is answering the questions, the who, the what, the when, the where, the how often. Maybe would fall within information, right? And then after we are able to present that information in a tabular form, then the individual can ask the question, the how, and try to figure out, you know, how is it that we have the results that we have, so that we can extract the lessons learned and then apply those lessons learned into future applications of our service, right? And then why? Because once you've applied that information into the future application of your services, then you can respond as to the why. Okay, and what that means is that if somebody is asking me, well, why are you working on this project? Well, I can answer the why, okay? Because we're a data-driven organization who has gathered information, and we've basically figured out how we were operating, and we extracted the continual service improvement aspects of things, and so that because of those readings, or because of those numbers, or because of those percentages, we were able to determine that this is the best path to take as you move into the future, right? So you're in essence making wise decisions. Nobody's gonna come and question, well, they might question, you know, why I'm doing what I'm doing, but you know, I'm always gonna be working within the process of data, information, and knowledge, right? So why am I working on this project? Why are you writing this documentation? Why are you releasing these articles, right? Why are you having these negotiations? Well, I can tell you why. Again, why? Because we were able to gather the information within a single repository and then use that information to interpret the patterns and the behaviors and the events and the little nitty gritty details, you know, the purchases or the cancellations or the lack of access to, you know, a certain aspect of the website, right? We can actually gather that information and tabulate it, which is it's really interesting. It really is, if you think about it, right? But that's the mechanics of how we're storing information into into ServiceNow, right? Or rather, ServiceNow provides you with the tools so that you can, in essence, build a repository where we can then manage the content of our database within an environment that ensures the success of the company. Okay, so I've tried to simplify here some of the service knowledge management system, right? And so in this case, the service knowledge management system stores information on behalf of the organization, such as, for example, CIS registers. And what CIS registers are is the continual service improvement recommendations that have ever been made, you know, what adjustments have ever been done based on those recommendations and what the results were, right? So the CIS registers is in essence a database of, you know, improvements that have been recommended and applied to the company, right? We also store information such as budgets, processes, policies, project plans, diagnostic scripts, right? This is all part of the service knowledge management system, right? And then we have other things within that system, such as the information security management system, the capacity management information system, and these are just some of the most important ones. The availability management information system, portfolio items, right? And we have also things such as the Definitive Media Library, which is a repository where we store logical information for within ServiceNow on behalf of the company that are assets of the company. I talked more about that in my ITIL lesson. So if all of this sounds a little obscure, don't worry about it. Go back to my ITIL Foundations certification course and watch some of those videos, and that will give you a better understanding of what's happening here. You know, in reality, I just gave you a lot of information that you don't necessarily need for the purpose of this exam, the ServiceNow exam, but you do need that information for the purpose of passing the ITIL certification exam. But what you do need to know for the purpose of ServiceNow certification administration is that, in essence, the knowledge base architecture is built in a hierarchical form, right? So that in essence you have cloud dimensions here. By the way, if you're confused here, this is just a name. If I go into incidents, I can see this filter here that creates breadcrumbs on my behalf, right? And that's in essence what you're looking up here. You know, it's just another tool that allows you the ability to navigate back and forth. But bottom line is that this is an article, you know, that was created by an individual within this company. And so, my educated guess is that they went through a process, right? And so even a video was inserted in here. So you see how it looks in the front end, right? But in the back end, if we open the hood, you know, we're looking at, the creation of an article. You know, it looks a little less graceful, if you will, right? But but this is in essence it, right? This is the engine that within ServiceNow, that, or the application, the modular application that gives you the ability to manage things that will be publicized within the company, right? You're not just putting things together and deploying them as if free for all, but again, just keep in mind that there has to be a process, and that's basically, in a nutshell, you know, the objectives for the ServiceNow objectives for the ServiceNow knowledge management, right? And so some of the things that you need to be able to answer, right, is what is knowledge management? Right, and it's in essence in ServiceNow, it's a modular application that gives you the tools necessary for you to view, search, flag a knowledge article, and or create, draft knowledge articles. Okay, what is the knowledge workflow? Right, and again, the knowledge workflow is those little tools and icons that the system provides for you, gives you the ability to figure out from a visual perspective where where that article is within the life cycle. Okay, what is the structure within ServiceNow? And as I mentioned, right, you have knowledge bases, you have categories, and then within categories, you have articles. And then on regards to security, right, when you're publishing these